The Party List System Act was signed into law in 1995 as a mechanism for marginalized groups to win seats in the House of Representatives. Under the law, 20% of the total members of the lower house must be party list representatives. Participants may be any organized group of persons provided they are from underrepresented sectors, including labor, peasants, fisherfolk, urban poor, indigenous cultural communities, elderly, handicapped women, youth, veterans, overseas workers, and yes, even professionals. How does the party list system make it easier to gain representation in the lower house? Well, the law states all you need for a seat in Congress under the party list system is at least 2% of the total votes. 20% of the total seats in Congress, that's equal to 59 seats available, and there are 134 party list groups vying for those seats this May. Now, the total number of party list votes in the last elections was about 32.4 million. 2% of that is roughly 650,000 votes. But since the party list law requires all 59 seats to be filled, party list groups can still get seats even if they don't get the full 650,000 votes. In 2016, the last group to secure a seat only had 240,000 votes. Now, a recent report on voter population showed us senatorial candidates need only to focus on the top vote-rich areas in Luzon to win a seat, seen here. Now, the magic number was about 14 million for senators in 2016. Party list groups have it much easier. Ako Bicol was the number one ranked party list in 2016, winning three congressional seats for just 1.7 million votes. It won by leveraging its popularity in Bicol with 350,000 votes from Camarines Sur alone and another 340,000 votes from Albay. The Trade Union Congress Party, Akbayan, Anak Pawis, Gabriela, ACT Teachers, and Bayan Muna, they all embody the underrepresented sectors mentioned in the Party List System Act and all won seats at the Batasan Pambansa in 2016. The other winners include former Manila Mayor Lito Atienza under the Buhay Party List, Jericho Nograles, son of former House Speaker Prospero Nograles under the PBA Party List, former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque, who was previously associated with Kabayan Party List before the group disowned him, businessman and PBA team owner Mikey Romero under One Pacman, and businessman and liquefied petroleum gas retailer Arnel T under LPGMA Party List. Now, the party list system has made it easier for underrepresented sectors to be elected into Congress. The question is, have other sectors found a way to abuse the system? For Dissecting Data, I'm Warren de Guzman.